You are already 85. Can't you take my servant
again?
Maybe she's the one of God.
Choose
for you to have a children. Abraham said, hey, I was thinking about it, but I was afraid of you.
Yes.
You gave me permission. Glory to Jesus. What happened? Ishmael came.
Ishmael had.
Not in God perfect way.
Yes, in
it was Sarah.
Amen. Sarah.
Hello.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
You need to be patient like Job. Between the promise and the fulfillment, there is a gap. Glory to Jesus. God came in Genesis 18, from verse 10 up to 15. After eating the source of Sarah, God was so happy and they spoke. Next year, I will come. At the same period, Sarah will conceive. Sarah, hey, she laughed. You eat just go. You know, there are people after eating, they can start to talk nonsense. That's good. And God asked Sarah, why did you laugh? And she lied. I didn't laugh. God said you did. But my promise shall come to pass. Nothing will change it. Your laughing will not change my promise. I said it, I will do it. At the same period, next year, you will bear a son. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Is it anything hard to God?
No.
God is asking Sarah, is it anything hard to the Almighty God to do?
No.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
There is a gap between the promise and the fulfillment. You have to master your emotions, your feelings. God has nothing to do with your feelings. Your emotion and feeling, they are like weather in Cape Town, changing all the time. Are you with me? Master your feelings and emotions. What God says, it has a time, the appointed time, to be fulfilled. At a God right time, it will be fulfilled. Hello?
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
Don't panic. There is a gap. Glory to Jesus. You know Joseph? In prison, interpreted the dream. The dreams for Pharaoh officials. He told the one who was in charge of bringing wine to the king. So when will you be to the palace? Remember me. The Bible says that man forgot Joseph. When you are in trouble, when God is testing you, your close friend will forget you. Hello?
Amen.
Don't complain. Oh, I was helping them. They are not true friends. You see now, I'm challenged. All they run away. They forgot Joseph. So remember me when you will be in the palace. That man forgot
Joseph
until the king had another dream. Say, he's about to dream. Oh, I remember. There is that slave Jew in the prison. I can call him, he can interpret for you. This is the God appointed time to lift you up. No one can stop it. At a God appointed time. Habakkuk was waiting. He was watching upon the hall. See and hear what God will say. Habakkuk chapter 2 from verse 1 up to 4. And the God that gave him a vision. He told him, write it down on the tablet. Do you have a tablet, cell phone? Write the vision on the cell phone, on the tablet. It has a time. It has an appointed time. Even if it seems to delay, it will be fulfilled. It has a time. And the God, the time is the best time for you. It has a right season. When it will be your season, the vision will be fulfilled. But there is a gap between the release of the promise and its fulfillment. Is where many people are abandoning things of God, Christianity, and the complicating things themselves. You have to wait. You have to be patient until God will fulfill His promise. Glory to Jesus. You can't push God to do before time. Nothing will happen before time. Nothing will happen after time. There is a time for the promise. The promise God has given you to be fulfilled. There is a time. There is a time. There is a time. One sister came to me. Samaruti. I prayed in my local language. Nothing. I prayed in French. Nothing. I prayed in other language spoken in the capital city. Nothing. Now, Murut, tell me in which language I must pray. It's not about the language. Every God promise as an appointed time. Wait for it. It can seem to delay. There is no delay with God. Lazarus was sick. But Jesus died again 2 days. And Lazarus died. Oh. When Jesus came, it was only ready 4 days. After he was buried. And the sister of Lazarus, Martha and Mary, they were blaming Lazarus. Jesus. Oh Lord. Just you were there. Our brother could not die. If you were there. Our brother could not die. Can God delay? No. Jesus told them from the beginning, this sickness is not unto death. It's so that the glory of God may be manifested. Even if you can die. Who is the author of life? Jesus is the life, is the way, is what again? Is the truth. Lord, they came to welcome Jesus. Lord, if you could be there. And the others would say, hey, he came late this man. Where was he all this time? He's only ready by the time. Other was saying, hey, he was opening the eyes of the plant. Can't he? Bring to life his friend. And Lazarus was Jesus' friend. And you, in John 15, Jesus said, is calling you friend. You are the friend of God. But delay is not a denial. Even if it can take time, it does not mean God will not fulfill it. It has a time. Glory to Jesus. Jesus said, your brother will come back to life. So that we know. When people will resurrect. Christian, you are believing God in the past, in the future, but you are not able to believe God for what can happen today. Hebrews 11 verse 1, when we define faith, faith is now. Tomorrow is hope. Faith is now. Are you getting me? Faith is now. Faith is now. Oh, glory to Jesus. The level of your faith will determine the improvement in your life. We determine your success or your failure. The level of your faith will determine your success, your failure, your improvement. If your faith is dormant, you are a failure. You will fail. Oh, glory to Jesus. The devil is targeting your faith. That's why Jesus, when he saw that the devil wanted to destroy Peter, Jesus told to Peter, the devil wanted to destroy you. He wanted to shift you like a weed. I prayed for you so that your faith will not fail. I prayed for you so that your faith may not fail. When you will come back, strengthen your brothers. Peter started in the flesh, Lord. If he's about to go to prison, we go together. If he's about to die, we die together. Jesus said, those are man of God. Glory to Jesus. When they came to arrest Jesus, all the disciples ran away. They ran away, starting by Peter. And the one woman stick to Peter around the fire said, you, I saw you with him. I saw you. I don't know. Even that accent. This one you are speaking is from Lobedo. I don't know him. And then Jesus looked at Peter. You are the one who were promising me to go in prison together, to die together. He looked at him. Peter started to cry. Peter, are you crying? You've already denied him. What they cry for? And they were so discouraged. He went back to fishing. But Jesus told him, when you will come back, strengthen your brothers. On the Pentecostal day, the power of the Holy Ghost came upon Peter. The same Peter stood. He told Israel, let all Israel be assured that Jesus, same Jesus, you crucified, God made him Lord and the Christ. He spoke boldly. 3,000 people were saved by one preaching of Peter. When you will come back, strengthen your brother. The devil wanted to destroy you. To attack your faith. That's why I prayed so that your faith may not fail. Amen. Oh, when your faith does not fail, That is the victory God has given you to challenge the old world. You will have many tribulations. But what makes Jesus to overcome, He has given it to you. Your faith is the victory to overcome whatever comes your way. Keep it up. Maintain it. Nourish it by the word. Day after day. Are you with me?
Amen.
By the word of Christ. Alive. And the spirit. And you know, faith is a spirit. That spirit, Caleb and Joshua had, when the congregation were panicking to conquer Jericho, Caleb said, as God is favorable to us, we will take that country. We will possess it. We will possess it. We will possess it. And the God said, my servant Caleb has another spirit. That spirit is that spirit of faith. Caleb believed with the same spirit of faith. He spoke, we will conquer the promised land. And the God said, he believed me, he will enter. But those who saw signs and wonders from Egypt and denied me, they will not inherit the promised land. Because of unbelief. Because unbelief will kill your faith. And kill yourself. Because of unbelief, all the died in the desert. Caleb and Joshua believed God. They entered the promised land with those who were born in the desert. What you need is your faith. What you need is the word in your spirit to maintain your faith. What is valuable to you is the word of God. It's not the money you are looking for. It's not the breakthrough you are looking for. It's not the healing you are looking for. What is valuable to you is the word of God in your spirit. Because faith comes by hearing, hearing the word of God. May the Lord maintain your faith alive in order to overcome any challenge you will face, in order to level any mountain ahead of you. May we stand and pray. Thank you.